thank you very much for the introduction. It's a great honour to be here. My name is Miles Pennington, and I'm very excited to be the prospective dean of the new UTokyo College of Design. So what I would like to do is to walk you through the vision for the new curriculum for the UTokyo College of Design. But before I start, I just want to point out this is the new logo for the college, and it's going to be in online on our new website, which will be launched shortly after this event, so please check it out later. So let's tell you a little bit about the curriculum. The most important part is the foundation of this curriculum is the combination of wide disciplinary knowledge and design methods and skills to solve social issues and challenges. This is what makes the program very distinct and will give the students confidence to become shapers of the future. So let's tell you how we teach the students wide disciplinary knowledge. Well, in the first year, we kick that off with what we call interdisciplinary foundations. So in this series of classes, each one of the faculty of the university teaches the fundamentals of that faculty. So for example, the Faculty of Engineering will do a whole series of classes that introduce the basic topics of engineering. And then the Faculty of Law will do the same, and so on, until each one of the faculties has delivered a very wide range of classes. So in 1 year, the students get this incredible view of the rich spectrum of knowledge that's taught at UTokyo. Then in years 2 and 3 of the program, we allow the students to follow their own curiosity and interests. We have over 100 electives from across the university that the students can choose from, and these we call interdisciplinary perspectives. So we organize those classes into 5 different clusters: environment and sustainability, technology frontiers and AI, governance and markets, healthcare and well-being, and culture and society. And in each one of those clusters, the students has approximately 20 classes to choose from. So in environment and sustainability, a student might do something like climate change basics, or they might take a nature conservation class, or even geoeconomics and sustainability challenges. The choice is up to them. Or in the technology frontiers and AI clusters, they might take something like the fundamentals of AI, or engineering design, robotics, aerospace engineering, or even the frontiers of physics. The reason why we want the students to learn this wide disciplinary knowledge because complex social issues require complex thinking. So we need the students to think from multiple different dimensions. That could be scientific, it could be economic, it could be cultural, it could be ethical. Unless students are actually looking at problems from all those different directions, they're not going to come up with meaningful solutions to change the world. And those classes will all be taught in English. And not only that, but we don't want students to take part in normal lectures. We're going to take an active learning approach. So students are going to be discussing and collaborating and critiquing and creating in those classes. And alongside the wide disciplinary knowledge program, we of course have a dedicated design program. And the design program is created to show students a really wide set of design methods and skills. So we kick off the year with a series of 8 workshops. Each one of these workshops introduces a different kind of approach to design. So it could be product design, speculative design, service design, or design and ethics. And alongside that, the students learn multiple design skills. So sketching, or prototyping, user research, intellectual property, knowledge understanding. The point is not to create one type of designer, but to show students multiple ways of working. And then in years 2 and 3, we do a series of what we call changemaker projects. So these are electives, and each one has a different topic or theme based around social issues or challenges. So one project could be on disaster resilience, another on social inclusion, and others on food and nutrition. And the students can select which ones they wish to partake in. So in these projects, the students start to integrate the learning from the classes, the interdisciplinary perspectives. They start to weave that knowledge into their design work, and this is how they connect the 2 pillars of the curriculum. as they get deeper into these projects, the important point is they're not just simply learning about design, but actually applying design with a purposeful meaning. And then in the early part of the fourth year, we have one of the most exciting elements of the course, and that is what we call off-campus experience. And we literally want the students to be away from university off-campus. The point of this is to take the learning outside of the classroom. They need to do something that's valuable to their education, but that could take many forms. They may do an internship with a leading company, or they may do a study abroad program, or volunteer to a charity, or do a field trip, or even create their own startup. So what we're trying to do in years 1 to 3 with this wide disciplinary knowledge program, the multiple creative design projects, and the off-campus experience, is to allow the students to create their own pathways through the curriculum, so that each one of them can follow their own curiosity and interests, and each one of them will eventually be a different type of, created different kinds of experiences for themselves. So no two students will be alike. And that is not a disadvantage, that is a great advantage. This is what we want to create, because that diversity is super important to help support this design-led and future-facing education environment. So, in the latter half of year 4 and year 5, the students do their capstone project. So this is their opportunity to bring all the learning from the curriculum so far into a creative design project. A really important part of our approach is what we call the open studio model. So students in the capstone will have a mentor, someone that gives them general guidance, but more importantly, they're going to be getting input, feedback, critique and challenge from a wide variety of other sources. That could be other students, of course, other tutors and faculties from the college, and visiting experts. And the point of doing that is firstly to make sure the students are creating their own self-directed projects, so they're making up the decisions and deciding where their projects are going. Secondly, it's to make sure that they create strong collaborative communication skills, and most importantly, that they come out of the program a very powerful, independent learner. Now, we are not going to set the themes or the topic for the capstones. This is entirely up to the students. And I think this is one of the most exciting parts of the curriculum, that we're really looking forward to seeing what the students will do, what they think is important. So some of them might create healthcare devices for the developing world, or software that helps financing be more equitable, or even new types of policy proposals for the environment or sustainability issues. It's entirely up to the students what they think is important and where they focus their creative power. What is common to all the capstone projects is a tangible output. So it doesn't have to be traditional product or service, or it could be, but we really want the students to push the boundaries of design itself, to think what is the right solution for this problem or challenge, and to create that so it really does form a meaningful change for society. And at the end of the program, there will be an exhibition. So we want the students to exhibit their work to the public and engage in multiple conversations and explain their work and their processes to a wider audience. So, see the world through design, then change it. This is our kind of program motto, and for us it perfectly captures what we want to achieve. We say see the world in the sense of observe and understand. We want the students to appreciate the problems and issues and opportunities that are all around them. And then it's through design. Design for us is the tool. It's not the be-all and end-all, but rather the method or the discipline that changes understanding into ideas and ideas into deployable innovations. So see the world through design, and the most important part, then change it. So we want talented people from Japan and around the world to come to the UTokyo College of Design and actually make meaningful change in the future. That is our goal. We're super motivated to try to achieve that, and we're going to be starting in fall of 2027. So thank you very much for listening. I'm really sorry my Japanese is not good enough yet to talk to you, and I hope it will be in the future. I look forward to talking to you, and thank you for your support.